Michael, the start of a new Premier League season. Tell me what your hopes and expectations are now.
For this game or
in general?
Well, I think it's a little early to talk about that. Just getting started right now. Well, actually, we have started already with the two games in the Europa League against Malmö. But Premier League-wise, we start off now. We talked a lot about the transfers and the transfer windows, and probably you will ask me one or two questions about that as well, again and again. So the reason I'm answering you like this is that I think we'll need to see the first games and go past especially the 1st or 2nd of September. I hope I will have my entire squad like it is now, maybe add one or something like that. But I think we'll need the first two or three rounds to see and to end the transfer window before I answer completely your question. I already said in the pre-season that my target overall would be in the Premier League to try to consolidate this team as a mid-team. In the first 2 years in the Premier League, Swansea 11th and 9th, which is very unusual for newcomers to end like that. And if we could do that, it would be absolutely fantastic. But again, let's wait couple of games and let's talk about it.
I remember you said here the back end of last season that you were very proud to finish 9th, but that to make the next step up, to break into the elite, to finish in the top 7-8, it would take, I think the figure you said, an investment of £100 million.
I'm very happy you asked me that question. So that gives me a possibility to because during the summer, you all know there have been a lot of things evolving my name and my figure. The only thing I don't remember if it was with Sky or with BBC, but just before the last game against Fulham, where we could be 9th or 8th, I was asked that, Michael, it's next season, whatever, if you win or lose today, 8th or 9th, it will be very, very difficult to improve that this season. Talking about the other season, I said, of course, a part of the cup was obviously is this not a once in a lifetime, but something you cannot count on every year, 2, 3, or 4, 5 years. But talking about the Premier League, I said, if we get arrive 8th, it's very, very difficult, because if you look on the top 7, well, you have the 3 teams, the 2 Manchester, Chelsea, fighting for the title. You have a couple of teams, Arsenal and Tottenham, about the 4th spot, and then you have still just below there and there trying to get into that as well, Liverpool and Everton. And then I said, I think, quote, that if you want to go up there and maybe even to go to the big boys, then you would need, I don't know, recall if I said a rich uncle coming in with £200 million of the door, obviously referring of some owners. And that phrase, I think, was used 10 or 12 times or even more during the summer. But that was it. What I wanted to say with that is that, and I still think that, I think the first 7 spots in the league, they are already there. So the rest of us, I think we play from 8th to 20. Then we still have Newcastle, which I think would be maybe number 8. But then the rest of us, we are more or less there. So I think we have to think that the last 11 or 12, that's our league. The other one, they already designed up there. And that was what I said.
Okay.
So I haven't asked to spend 100 or 200 or £300 million in transfer.
Okay, you've spent.
So what we, I can exclude here absolutely that Gareth Bale, Suarez, and Rooney, we are not interested.
We'll come on to Rooney.
Okay.
You spent about, say, a quarter of that 100 million figure. Do you feel you spent it wisely, and what kind of impact do you expect that investment to have?
well, a quarter, that's a fourth part. I don't think we did that. We spent a lot of money in one player. That's true in Boney. The other four, I think, one was on a free transfer, and the other two Spaniards were very, very cheap. And then John Joe, and then Boney. The thing is that with forwards, players scoring goal, everybody wants them, you know, at all levels, from the top level, from the top teams fighting for the winning the Champions League and the league titles, and down to the bottom teams to avoid the relegation. So they're so difficult to find, and they're very expensive. We've seen other clubs spending a lot of money in forwards can score goals, because goals are the most important thing in football. If you score goals, you get points, and with points you can try to reach your targets. So, but we signed five players, and I think they're adapting fine to the squad, and that's important. But there's a lot of clubs spending a lot of money. We can see even our neighbours here, great rivals next season, Cardiff. Some big signings there, Danish forward, Chilean middle, in midfield, and Cogna, and for a lot of money, more than a quarter. And so that just means that there's a huge competition. I don't want to go into the debate of if all the players who have been signed in the Premier League in general, they are all worth their money. We know that when you have money and you come as a Premier League club to wherever you go to buy players, you know that the other clubs, they're already doing like this because they know there's a lot of money here. So they ask more. And it's what you're willing to pay in a given situation.
Tell me your thoughts on starting against Manchester United. Is that a good start for you? You look at what's happened at that club. New manager, highest profile player, seemingly in dispute with the club. Are they vulnerable?
Well, that's a question that I have to be very careful to answer, no? Because I could sit here and say, wow, it's the best moment you can play Man United, then 3-0, we lose 3-0 on Saturday, and then you can ask me the same question again. It's never the right moment to play a Man United or top team like that, because there's always quality. But said that, we know we have to play them. So I think in the beginning it's not a bad moment. It's not a bad moment. I don't want to go into it. Obviously, you're going to ask me about Rooney and all that case, but I don't want to go into that debate, because it's not my problem, because it's not my club. I'm not the manager there. I have to look into the 11 who will play, and whatever they do, there will still be a very, very strong squad they can come up with. I don't really know. I have to expect everything. Nothing and everything. I don't know if Rooney is playing or not playing. I don't know if Carrick, he didn't play last night. Young, are they fit playing? I have to make different teams, squads, and to expect really everything from them. And but overall, I say if we have to play all the big ones, and we have. To start with them, or in the beginning of the season, is not a bad moment. I prefer now than maybe in October, November.
Okay. And,
but it's still difficult. Yeah? So don't laugh at me if they beat us. Huh?
I heard what you said about Rooney, and that's not your problem. Just tell me though, you've been in that situation at clubs where a very high-profile player is in dispute. What kind of turbulence? What kind of disruption does that have within a club, and do you feel Man United may be affected by that on Saturday?
I've not tried that. I played in big clubs myself. I've never had situations like this where one of the top players really wanted to leave, and he was still there. So I can't really answer that question. Of course, it's a question that it's not only me have been asked this. I think David Moyes will be asked that same questions over and over again. The rest of us, we read the press as well. And there are some cases in in the Premier League this summer with some high-profile players, Bale, Suarez, and Rooney. In the end of the day, I don't know if they all three will stay, all three will leave, or whatever. But again, Rooney plays. Yesterday, last night he played, so I have to take that into consideration, that it is a possibility. Okay, then you can tell me, no, he will not play. He may not, but he may play. Well, I don't know. He played yesterday. He seemed quite fit to me. So I have to take that into consideration, that it is a possibility, playing him or not. If it affects the other players in the squad, I don't know. I really don't know. If they don't have to answer the same question, they can just... If they don't have to do that, I don't think it have a huge influence. It's maybe more the... Yeah, from the outside, from the player itself, Rooney in this case, and maybe the manager or the board, but the rest of the players, they're just training every day and preparing themselves for the games, I think.
Okay. Leon said earlier that he thought David Moyes as a manager perhaps had the measure of Swansea with Everton, very good results recently. Does that have an impact, an influence with David Moyes and Manchester United?
I think when if you have success against a certain team or certain style, doing in a certain way, you will try to bring that along to every time you play that team. It's true that I can only talk for the last season. We played Everton twice. In the first, yeah, they did very well against us. I know the year before they did as well. But still, we created 5 or 6 chances, even if we played the last half an hour. I know we lost 3-0, and we deserved to lose. But that was because of the first 30 minutes. After that, we created so many chances. And in the away game, we had a drawless... it was a draw without goals, 0-0. I think we did quite well there after a very hard, difficult week, I remember, in January. So, yeah... I don't know if Man United will play in the same way like Everton did. I think Man United, they have their own style, different players. So but certain things David Moyes may bring into his new team, new club, because they worked for him. But I mean, as a manager, you can't say, oh, I always done like this. Now my new team, they will have to play exactly like the others. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, Swansea is not playing the same way as Mallorca did, just to say in my case. So I don't expect 100% Everton, Man United to be the same as Everton.
Transfer window is still open. Are you still looking to do any business, bring any players in? And are you fearful that you could still be vulnerable to players leaving?
The possibility is always there. That's why I answered you your first question about... what to expect from this Premier League. Let's see what happens, not only in Swansea, but in general. I wouldn't sit here and say, I think this club will win the title, and then suddenly there's another club who make two fantastic buys, so or the other way around. From our point of view, going out, I hope that the players are here, the regulars, they will stay. I think we created a very good squad, competitive squad. We may still have something to do, and especially up front. I think I've said it more than once. I think we need one more alternative, different kind of forward. But then a part of that, I think it's small things. But again, have to be open for everything, prepared for everything, because if suddenly one of our players is going to leave, then we have to find a replacement.
Picking up on that, Michael, if I may, have you made an offer for Kevin Doyle?
No.
Is he a player that you might be inquiring about?
I don't want to go into debating and names here, because I think there have been so many names linked to Swansea, and. I think it was another manager who once said, maybe more than one manager said, if only half of the players linked to our club, we actually signed them, then I would be a manager for 36 players. And we want a short squad in this moment. I think we have 22. It's more or less what we will end up with.
But the striker is your priority?
Yes, because goals are so important. And we signed Boney. That was great to put take a little of the pressure off the shoulders of Michu. But still, we need another, a different kind of striker as well. Because hopefully we'll play many, many games. That depends what we're doing in the two games against the Romanian side in the end of August. But if we go into the group stage, then it could be 30 games before New Year. So we need one more.
How's the rest of the squad? De Guzman?
Yeah, he's out. That's it was so unlucky. I mean, in a training session yesterday, crossing my fingers that nothing happened. It's always a possibility, and the more they play, the more possibility you have to get injured. But yeah, the other guys, they should be fit. Let's see today. We're training at 4 o'clock here, so Ashley, Ben, Michelle, Boney will be back tonight. A nice friendly game in the United States, so he will be back late this night with jet lag and everything. But yeah, what we do for the national teams for a good friendly game.
I take it you're not very happy with preseason friendlies then?
No, but this is the last year. I think I've said it many times. First of all, I want to say to play for your country is great. We should be proud in a club like Swansea to have many players playing with their national teams. But to have a friendly game 3 days before the league kicks off, it's ridiculous. It's really. But fortunately, it's the last season. It will be like this. You all know that from next season, UEFA will cancel this game. So intelligent job.
That's about Ashley Williams.
No one wants to play that game. No one.
You roll back the years though with you play. Ashley Williams had a little ding-dong with Robin Van Persie. Things were said in previous games. Do you expect any niggle from that?
No, I think Van Persie recovered and scored a lot of goals after that. So it was an accident there. I think it things were said and things are said in, on a pitch when your pulse is up there. And even things were said after the game, but just after. But then I think that was that. And I just to finish this, I just remember when we played the last game for at home for so Alex Ferguson up there against Man United. I think it was a corner for Man United, and Van Persie was taking it, and our fans was just singing. In a funny way, are you still alive? And he did, instead of getting angry, he just did like that. And I think that says a lot of things, that in the moment it happened in that game here, angry words were said and all that, and I think that's okay, because in that moment you were up there, it was 1-1, I think, and you know, you say things, you do things, but then finish, and then it's over, and then I think that reaction, month later, in a different environment, in a game, much more relaxed atmosphere, showed it, that it wasn't anything to be worried about.